Assalamu alaikum. Hello everyone. I'm Farjana Tarin from Department of Environmental Science and Disaster Management, Noakhali Science and Technology University. Now I'm going to share some information about Millennium Development Goals. In September 2000, leaders of 189 countries gathered at the United Nations headquarters and signed the historic Millennium Declaration, in which they committed to achieving a set of measurable goals that provide a framework for development planning for countries around the world by the target date of 2015. The Millennium Development Goals are commonly described as a roadmap for world development by 2015. Millennium Declaration set 8 mutually reinforcing time-bound development goals and related targets for progressively eradicating poverty. Goal number 1, halving extreme poverty and hunger. Goal number 2, achieving universal primary education. Goal number 3, promoting gender equality. Goal number 4, reducing under 5 mortality by 2/3. Goal number 5, reducing maternal mortality by 3/4. Goal number 6, reversing the spread of AIDS, malaria, and TB. Goal number 7, ensuring environmental sustainability. And goal number 8, developing a global partnership for development. Millennium Development Goals help focus national and international priority setting goals and targets which are limited in number. Thank you.
Hello guys, Assalamu alaikum. I am Tania Akhtar. I would like to talk about the first goal of Millennium Development. The first goal of Millennium Development was to eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. Do you believe or not? It is the first thing for human being, that is to remove our hunger. We all and our parents do work a lot of, but why? Only if we do eat a good meal for 3 times, and there are so many people who are working so hard to get only 1 meal for a day. So we can say we are so privileged that we can have 3 meals and other snacks too. Now, as there are so many hungry people and there are so many poor people, so the very first goal of MDGs was extreme poverty and hunger. Extreme poverty is very important word. This kind of word we can see in African country. We have poor people in our country, but Bangladesh gradually growing very good. Now we are developing country and believe that Bangladesh will be do better in the coming days. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Nishan and I will present you the Millennium Development Goal number 2. The goal 2 of MDG is about achieving the universal primary education. There is only one target under this goal that says ensure that by 2015 children everywhere, boys and girls, everyone will be able to complete a full course of primary schooling. Now, why is primary education this important? Because we all know education is the backbone of a nation, and every single human, every single kid has the right to earn at least the primary education, at least the most basic education in their life.
UNDP says about 57 million children don't even attend to primary education. The Guardian says that number is 70 million. 4 out of 5 children live in rural areas. At the same time, the learning ability of rural children is compromised by hunger.
According to UNDP, the number of out-of-school children fell almost half by 57 million, and according to The Guardian, that is 70 million, which I mentioned earlier, but it was nearly 100 million in 2000 when this goal was adopted. That's from the report from 2015. Now it's 2021, so we need an updated report which has not been established yet. Let's hope for the best. Passing over to my next teammate, this is Nisha.
The goal number 3 is promote gender equality and empower women. They have some target of goal number 3. The main target is eliminate gender disparity in primary and secondary education, preferably by 2005, and in all levels of education no later than 2015. other targets are, number one, the developing countries as a whole have achieved the target to eliminate gender disparity in primary, secondary, and tertiary education. Number two, globally about 3/4 of working age men participate in the labor force compared to half of a working age woman. Number three, women make up 41% of paid workers outside of agriculture, an increase from 35% in 1990. Number four, the average proportion of women in parliament has nearly doubled over the past 20 years. Number five, women continue to experience significant gaps in terms of poverty, labor market, and wages, as well as participation in private and public decision making.
Assalamu alaikum. I am Mohammed Masum Billah. I am going to describe the COVID-19 effects on the first three goals of Millennium Development Goals. Let's start. The first goal of MDGs was to eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. COVID-19 had a critical effect on extreme poverty and hunger. World Bank reported COVID-19 may push 85 to 115 million people to extreme hunger and poverty. It has also said that 8 of 10 new poor will be in middle-income countries. The second goal of MDGs was to achieve the universal primary education. Almost all educational institutions of the world are closed for several months due to COVID-19 outbreaks. Though then online classes have been started in some countries, but it is not quite enough to reach quality education to everyone. According to UNICEF, it is a universal crisis and its impact will be lifelong for primary students. COVID-19 has affected the gender equality and women empowerment. Many women working on health and educational sector have lost their jobs due to COVID-19 pandemics. It is mostly happening in third world countries in the world. So it is decreasing the magnitude of women empowerment. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.